God of mercy, look kindly on your servant Rita, who has now set down the burden of her years. As she served you and her family and her faith faithfully and generously and lovingly throughout her life, may you give her now the fullness of your peace and joy in heaven. We give you thanks for her long life now caught up in your eternal love. And we make this our prayer in the name of Jesus, who is our brother and our friend and our risen Lord, and who lives forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated now as we listen to our readings from Sacred Scripture, and our first reading will be read by Rita's daughter-in-law, Denise.
A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything, and a time for everything under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. What advantage has the worker from his toil? I have considered the task which God has appointed for men to be busied about. He has made everything appropriate to its time and has put the timeless into their hearts. Without men's every discovering, from beginning to end, the work which God has done. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
for second reading will be proclaimed by Rita's granddaughter, Gloria.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Are you unaware that we who were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we might too live in the newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like this, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person who has been absolved from sin, if then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
Three of our parish who are
here in spirit, all of us joined together in offering our condolences to Patrick and Tenny and Denise and to Nick and to James and Ashley and Cindy and Lauren and all of the extended family and friends and neighbors who are here today as we gather this Mass to mourn Rita's passing, to celebrate her life for 91 years, and most importantly, as people of faith, which obviously she was a great and deep believer in the faith, most importantly, to celebrate her new life with the Lord forever, which is what this Mass of Christian burial is all about. As we gather around the Easter candle, the central symbol of our faith in the mystery of the resurrection, this candle was carried into the church on Holy Saturday night. The darkened church was the only light that was carried into the church. And then all the other, for everybody here at that Mass, lit their candle from this light here and symbolizes in a very dramatic way, you know, that our faith, you know, catches on. It's caught as well as taught, and that, you know, and that's what she taught and lived so well, so beautifully, so consistently in her life as a faithful Catholic. And I was talking to, you know, Nancy beforehand, and Nancy would bring Rita to church, sat over here all the time. I'm only here 5 years, I didn't meet her, but Nancy was telling me all the time, coming to church here, celebrating the Eucharist, celebrating with the family, and faith is all about. And even when she couldn't come here any longer, she watched the Mass on television. So that deep-rooted faith in the mystery of life, in the mystery of family and faith, in the mystery of, you know, who we are about as disciples of Jesus. And, you know, our faith tells us very clearly that from the body of our earthly dwelling lies in death, and we being ever left in the dwelling place of the Lord forever and ever. That's what our faith tells us. And so, as people of faith, then we know that last Sunday, October 3rd, she passed from this life to eternal life, that she was reunited with Charlie, her husband, after 14 years, and her parents, Giuseppe and Rose, and her brother Michael, and her sister Greta, and all the extended family and friends who preceded her into the kingdom of heaven. And one of the beautiful lines of the ritual is that as people of faith, we know we shall see her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. That's what the mystery of our faith tells us. It doesn't take away the pain, the loss, the separation, but it gives us a place to put our sorrow and loss in the confident trust of that faith that she lived and believed. Passed on to everybody here. And so, Denise, as you read in that first reading from the book of Ecclesiastes, there's an appointed time for everything, time to be born, time to die, time to gather stones, and time to scatter them. There's an appointed time for everything. And so, welcome to anyone for the last day or so. You know, you said that lived with you guys for 38 years, and as she said so beautifully, it was sad to let her go, and yet it was okay. As she told her, it was okay for her to go back with her dad and her parents, her uncle and aunt, and because he was there for you. And that's what our faith tells us, you know, the mystery of the resurrection, that we try to live our lives as fully as possible and to the best of our abilities, and hopefully drawing upon the heritage that our faith passed down from one generation to the next, and knowing that in living the faith that God is there. So I know that my mom grew up in Brooklyn, and as you mentioned, being privileged, spoiled by the Father. And what a beautiful gift that's what, you know, parents who spoil their children so as to, you know, live as fully as possible in this world, in this challenging world. And it seems to me that family and faith, with a lot of lines, sisters and brothers, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for us, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
Our responses, hear our prayer. In baptism, we receive the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For our sister Rita, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, may she be raised up on the last day. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Rita seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy. Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known you alone. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the deceased relatives and friends of Rita, especially for Charlie, her husband, Giuseppe and Rose, her parents, Michael, her brother, and Laura, her sister, and all of her friends. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all those who helped Rita, especially for Kenny, Denise, Nicholas, Lauren, James, and Ashley. May they have the reward of their goodness. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here in faith, that we may be gathered today again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. And to Mary, our Lady of the Rosary, together we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. God of loving kindness, listen favorably to our prayers, strengthen our belief that your Son has risen from the dead, and our hope that your servant Rita will also rise again through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
We beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Rita, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Welcome her into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, St. Rose, the Rocher, St. Bruno, St. John Vianney, the Curator of Ars, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Your hands over your heart.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant us, strengthened by it, our sister Rita may come to the eternal table of Christ in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Rita. May our farewell express affection for her. May it ease the sadness and strengthen our hope. One day, we know, as people of faith, we shall see her again. We shall see her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Our sister Rita to her place of rest.